Chapter 9, The Power of a Press Kit, Not Just for the Big Boys. Christopher Morley once said, "The big shots are only the little shots who keep shooting." Press kits are not just for big corporations. They're for you, the performer and musician. A press kit is like a resume of your band, a collection of information and articles put together to spark interest in your music. And the goal is to create a press kit that will grab the reader's attention, create a killer presentation that helps them have a visual image of you and makes them want to know more about you. It used to be that press kits were pretty cut and dried, but with the new technologies, it makes it easier to present your information in a more exciting way. Remember the power of Kinko's. Let's talk about several different types of press kits. The traditional press kit is a collection of articles and information packaged in a presentation folder and sent through the regular postal service mail. A digital press kit is more exciting and has more capabilities to show what you're really about. You can have audio and video clips for your customer to hear and see you in action. And the digital press kit can be put on different formats like DVD, CD, or even downloaded from your web page. And nowadays, with hundreds, if not thousands of others competing for attention from the press, you'll need something that will stand out from the crowd. The traditional paper press kits can only accomplish so much, but digital press kits are cutting edge and a cost-effective way to promote your music. By using the latest in multimedia technology, you can bring your product to life and create a story that's certain to get lots of attention. And your prospective customer will love the ease of having all the information and artwork they need right at their fingertips, everything contained on a single interactive CD accessible from either Mac or PC. Just think, no more last-minute phone calls requiring you to send a picture, a video clip, or a biography. And with high-speed internet access, you can download high-quality, press-ready color photos from a website. Bios, photographs, video clips, press clippings, everything the press could ever need is just one click away. And using this type of press kit will also save you money on postage and time going to the post office. So what's in a press kit? Here are some ideas about what to include in your press kit. First is a cover letter. It's very important to write personally to each contact. If this note is a form letter, you'll lose your reader and not get the job. You must make a good impression with a short, concise message. Include a brief description of your music and introduce your contact person or manager. Let them know up front why they should care about what you're telling them and why using you would be a benefit to them. Understand something. Yours is not the only letter they're going to read, so you want them to remember you. Use a bold font or lettering to highlight key points. Let your readers know you're available for an interview and how they can get in touch with you. Second is a business card. Include several cards, one for the recipient and others to give to a friend or associate. Also, make sure that your cards match everything in the press kit. Include your logo, your name, and ways to reach you. And please, never get cheap ones. Make sure they're tasteful and spare no expense. These are a pocket-sized reflection of who you are. Another thing to include are recent articles. Keep an ongoing file of your press coverage and use the most recent in your press kit. And avoid using old news. That will appear as if you have nothing going on. Next are recordings. If you have a CD, DVD, or video, mail it along with your press kit. And when possible, send an internet link where the reader could listen online. And be sure your audio is top quality. First impressions last forever, and you probably won't get a second listen if your first one was poor quality or not produced and recorded well. Another great idea is a list of testimonials. This is a collection of letters from people for which you've worked, and they've written to compliment your talent, professionalism, and performance. How do you get these to add to your press kit? Well, ask for them. Be sure to request these letters of recommendation from the venues where your performance was a success. Next are biographies, or simply bios. These are just short sketches charting each member's history and musical experience. Don't give your life story. Just pertinent information about how you got from point A to point B and where you're headed. Next, include a fact sheet. This is possibly the most useful element of the press kit and also the easiest to compose. The fact sheet contains no salesmanship and no filler. It's simply an overview of the factual information of who's involved, and there are no hard and fast rules on what goes into a fact sheet. So here's a list of some things to consider. How about the artist's hometown? Members' names and the instruments they play. CD release information. You might want to include sales figures. Touring dates, recent dates, upcoming events, management and record label contact information. You may include producer and recording studios that you've been involved with. Show the type of crowds you've played for and the number of people at each event. Remember, this is a fact sheet. Keep it just that. Don't make claims that aren't true. Figures don't lie. What you want to do in this fact sheet is show proof that your band has audience appeal. This is what a record company is looking for. The next items to include are posters, flyers, and brochures. Include a sample of any of the marketing material of your band, and again, don't be cheap. These should be professionally done. You have one chance to make a good first impression. Here's a thought. How about a list of frequently asked questions? This helps customers to think of questions to ask you during an interview. Be sure to include descriptive, well-thought-out answers, and be careful here not to sound too proud of yourself. Let me say it again. Yours is not the only press kit they're going to read. It might be one of 100. So let me give you one more major tip about press kits. Packaging is the key to getting noticed. Start off by placing your kit in an envelope the customer can't miss. If you're emailing the press kit, make your subject line a catchy one. Package the material in a nice presentation folder for a professional look. Take your time and spend enough time on it to do it right. Realize the power of pulling up to the red carpet in a limousine. A professional presentation raises the value of your product. Why do you think corporations spend so much money on packaging? Would a jar of spaghetti sauce taste just as good in a plain glass jar? Of course it would. But when you put a beautiful label on it with a photo of a garden fresh tomato glistening with the morning dew, you don't mind paying extra for it. That's the power of packaging. Relate that to your press kit. Now let's talk about Al Gore's greatest invention, the Internet. Contrary to what Mr. Gore said, he did not invent the Internet. Tipper Gore did. Well, the real truth is, it's the best way to communicate with the rest of the world. By developing your own web page, you do present your identity to the world, and information and details about you are now accessible in places on Earth that would have never heard of you before. So armed with that knowledge, what are the essential traits of a great website? Let's begin with your own web surfing habits. After you visit a site and find yourself staying a while, what was it about that site that makes you stay? I call it eye candy, something that makes your eyes stay on the page. Flashy graphics are nice, but don't go overboard. If you choose to have music playing on your page, make sure that it's short and not too loud. This becomes very annoying, and people won't stay on your page. Provide credible, original content in as many forms as possible. Original content is the most important trait of a great website. Let your reader know you're selling your music business through your web page. Provide valuable, timely information to your visitor. And update the information on your website regularly. Stale websites say, "Been there, done that." For the information to be valuable, it should be well edited. And perhaps the only thing worse than not having a web page is having one that's out of date and not well maintained. Make your pages as easy to read as possible. Black text on a white background is the easiest to read. I've seen some nearly impossible to read pages that use backgrounds the same shade as the text, like dark text on a dark background and vice versa. So if you're using a background, then stick with lighter shades. The Internet is an interactive, dynamic, and rapidly changing communication medium that your website should reflect. well-organized, edited, and timely original content set in an attractive, interactive, and consistent format. These are some traits of great websites. I like to think that my website is a reflection of my own music, so use yours to portray what you're all about. But the true power of a website is that it's nothing more than a billboard for your business. It's a paid commercial advertisement. It's wonderful if you sell some product from it, but